The aim really was to find out if companies in the UK and the US are as secure as they ought to be. We wanted to find out if identity and access to different levels of data within companies are at the heart of any problems there might be. And it's interesting, I think, especially in the context of some major breaches there's been, the likes of Sony and JP Morgan. And throughout the survey, there were clear and consistent differences between attitudes of the UK and the US respondents. There were really three things of interest, I think, that came out around accessing data. The first point is ex-employees and contractors, the potential risks involved and leaving data vulnerable by not keeping control of their accounts and access. The second thing, almost a third of people in the UK, 32%, believe it would be easy for a former employee to log in and access systems or data with old passwords, and this compared to over half, 53%, in the US. The third point is that over half of our respondents admit it can take a week or more to remove access and passwords to sensitive data or systems for someone no longer with the company. And I'm sure if we went out into our offices today and asked around, anybody that's been with the company for less than 6 months has probably got access to some sort of system or data from their original company. The survey showed that 44% of all UK respondents admit that more than 10% of their staff have privileged access to data. Now, what we're talking about when we say privileged access might be a database administrator or someone who has access to all the data, all the customer records, all the credit card details, whereas a particular clerk or something would only, a non-privileged user would just have access to particular areas of that data. Giving employees elevated access to these privileged accounts, as they're called, critical data, access to critical data, applications, network devices, you're giving them the keys to the kingdom. Basically, it's the front door, keys to the front door of your organisation, and you need to be very careful with who you give such access to. Particularly in banking environment, you'll find that employees move around from department to department. So what you might have is a situation where somebody that had privileged access, maybe a database administrator who had access to all the data within your financial systems or customer records or something like that, that person then moves into being a dealer or a broker or whatever might be relevant in that banking organisation. If the privileged access isn't removed from where that person used to be, they can actually become like poacher and gamekeeper. They can do trades and then hide them behind themselves using their existing privileges. The survey found that over half, 57% of people in the UK admit they need to do a better job of monitoring who has access to data. So that implies to me that there's concern around levels of access and people are worried about it. 34% admit they share access credentials with other employees often, and 32% share access with contractors. And of those who allow contractors to access six systems, 68% of them believe they could access data with old passwords, which is very concerning. I think there's three things that financial organisations can learn from the report, and the things that were highlighted in the report were stale access to systems, especially people who've left the company who still have access and shouldn't have it. There were concerns around privileged access, that was the second point as well, which is especially important to financial organisations where they have very, very valuable data. And the third thing was inadequate monitoring of access, which obviously needs to be improved. So the ways to address these, in terms of the first one, the stale access, you really need to keep on top of provisioning and especially deprovisioning of access. As people move around inside a financial organisation, you really cannot have, you need separation of duties and you need to take away privilege as they move from one place to another. It's very important to keep on top of the fact that they have appropriate access. Secondly, keeping very tight control of privileged access, really exactly the same as the first applies. Privileged access is dangerous, the keys to the kingdom effectively you're giving people by giving them privileged access, and they'll have access to the data that keeps your business running. So it's very important that it's kept tight control of the access there. And also improve monitoring, especially in the tightly regulated environment of financial services and such like. You need to be monitoring, you need to be able to prove who has access to what, when it was changed, why they have access, and what they did with that access.